police officer is sitting in prison even after a judge said his trial was full of holes. The officer was convicted for killing a man in 1996 who he believed was about to strike his father on the head with a baseball bat. He spent 11 years in prison, but what happened after that is bizarre. Let's bring in our Deb Fayrick. Deborah, you've been following this case. Fill us in on the details.
And Randy, those pictures you see, that's him out just a couple of years ago. But what is so incredible is that this shooting was triggered by an argument between the police officer's father and 37-year-old Charles Campbell. It started over a parking space and escalated fatally when Campbell pulled out a baseball bat.
Guys.
I was convicted of second-degree murder with depraved indifference in 1997, and I was sentenced to 20 years to life.
New York City police officer Richard DiGuglielmo served 11 years in prison before a judge tossed out his conviction and he was sent home. His friends and family celebrating his release. When you walked out,
it was surreal. I couldn't believe it. My ankles weren't shackled, and I was like, wow, this is real.
A free man, DiGuglielmo spent 2 years rebuilding his life. He got a job, an apartment, a wife. Then just as suddenly, in a twist of the criminal justice system, it was all taken away.
I still cannot adjust being back here. It is difficult. It is difficult.
Deb, it really is a bizarre case. I mean, it seems to have cast a lot of doubt, in fact, on the county, Westchester County there in New York. So why was he sent back to prison?
You know, well, what happened is an appeals court judge, the one who overturned his conviction, slammed prosecutors, saying that they had a win-at-all-cost mentality. The judge also said that the officer had been improperly charged. So when he let him out, he said, look, there's not going to be a trial. There can't be a second trial. But prosecutors actually appealed this decision. A higher court reinstated the guilty verdict. So not only was Richie DiGuglielmo sent back, but the court made sure that the 2 years he'd been out rebuilding his life, that those 2 years were also tacked on to his sentence.
My.
When we reached out to the Westchester County District Attorney and local police, they simply refused to respond to our interview requests.
What about witness statements? Did those change or were they not introduced?
And that's a big part of this. The big issue that came up was whether police had actually forced witnesses to change their original stories. One witness who actually was closest to the shooting said he was repeatedly picked up by police until he changed the story. So even though at the beginning he said this was definitely self-defense, no question about it, at the trial he said that while the bat was up in the air, it was not swinging. Well, the judge who basically set DiGuglielmo free, basically said, look, had the jury known that this man was questioned again and again and again to change his story, then the verdict would likely have been different.